Hello and welcome to Big Picture. I am Vishal Dahiya, and today we're going to talk about the new guidelines which have been put in place by the central government vis-a-vis the COVID-19 containment zones and the lockdown norms therein as well. What the central government is saying is that now that the positivity rate of vis-a-vis the COVID-19 and the overall total number of active cases in the country have come down considerably in the second wave. If you make a comparison to its peak in the first or second week of May, the center has advised the state governments that they should not rush into relaxing the lockdown norms or containment zone norms. Rather, they should look at the ground situation and the positivity rates in specific areas and then take a considered decision out there. So today we're going to talk about these aspects as to what exactly should be the strategy. And for more on this, we're joined by two distinguished experts. Let me first introduce them to you, beginning with, we have with us Professor N.K. Ganguly, former Director General of ICMR. And we're also joined by Dr. Lekha Bhatt from the Central University of Tamil Nadu. Welcome, both of you. Let me begin with you, Professor Ganguly, and let's start by understanding the relevance and the significance of, these norms vis-a-vis the containment zones or the lockdown norms, because it has been almost, more than a year now when we first witnessed the first lockdown, which was put in place last year when we were struck by the first wave of COVID. And so far, there have been several tweaks in this particular policy. One, how these norms or this strategy has worked on the ground, and where do we stand today?
Actually, Vishal, I'm very happy with this particular direction which they have given. For the first time, government has explained why it has given this. So one of the reasons which it has given, that which they have studied the worldwide and they have studied our patchy distribution. So if we read between the line, they have said that a number of cases, although have come down, but not have come down enough. So it is not the right time to finish the lockdown. If we really want to gain into this, we need to strengthen this. It has also said that the situation in south of India has not improved to that extent. So nation, anywhere there is corona, we need to be vigilant. So this is what, if you read between the line, this is one, a very clear message. The second clear message it has given a matrix. That the positivity rate, if it is 10% or more, you have to fight. It has given, if the bed occupancy is 60% or more, you have to go on fighting. So again, it has provided a matrix on which you wish to work. But it has also said that you need to do the testing, tracking very vigorously. It has also said that there, in the areas, there will be need to do door-to-door surveillance to detect cases, because many people do not come out and get tested. So active surveillance for the first time has been introduced in the MHA directive. Mm-hmm. Then it has given certain cautions that maintain the infrastructure, don't destroy the infrastructure, the oxygens, the beds, the PPEs, the ventilators, the daily use of the ventilators, ambulances, the trained manpower. Please maintain it. Don't dismantle it. Okay. So this has been a very clear directive, which we did after the first day. We dismantled that. Mm-hmm. So it has given a directive that please don't dismantle it. Then it has, again, as it has said that you enhance testing and other, it has given a way out for a practical testing. It said that you do antigen testing. And it has also empowered the industry and other houses to take care of the testing of their workers. so that they can work appropriately. Then it has given few more indicators, which is very important. It has said that surveillance is a very important part of your activity. And surveillance means molecular surveillance also. And this surveillance need to be really analyzed, and you come up with the projections and containment projections and other projections. Mm-hmm. So this is again which has gone, because there's just not a directive that you open 50% or do 50% or this or that. It has given lot of in-between line advices to the to the different states and different areas.
Okay.
It has also emphasized on point of care, so that our agricultural workers, which are 50% of our workforce, are not neglected. So it has stated states which are dealing with special purposes, they need to take care of those areas. Like state of Punjab, large number of migrant laborers go to state of Punjab and Haryana. Mm-hmm. So they have to take care of them, and so it has empowered the states to take appropriate measures in the lockdown or easing of the lockdown.
Okay.
It also has given few more directives which are important, that it has allowed mm-hmm. now to buy medicines, essential medicines, from anywhere in the world.
Exactly.
So you have, the states have that power, the central government has those power. It has also asked the companies to ramp up and regulatory things, so that remdesivir, so that liposomal amphotericin B, more licenses have been given, more regulatory things have been ramped up. So mm-hmm. it has also taken care that no drug scarcity occurs.
So it's quite an exhaustive, guidelines out there, as you're pointing out, Dr. Ganguly. Let me also bring in, Dr. Lekha Bhatt here. Dr. Bhatt, your views on, these highlights which have been pointed out by Dr. Ganguly and which are there in the central government's advisory vis-a-vis dealing with, the situation right now, or we say the road ahead from here onwards. And specifically, if you're talking about southern states, as Dr. Ganguly was saying, some of these states, the positivity rate is still more than 10% in some areas there.
Vishal, it is an appropriate time in which this new guidelines have been brought up by the central government. The case positivity rate in the country as a whole is coming down. The recovery rate is increasing. The number of fatalities in general is coming down. So we are in a hopeful situation that we will be able to control the second wave of COVID. Mm-hmm. However, we have to look forward. There is a possibility that we might end up with a third wave immediately, or maybe after some time. It's an entirely new situation. So it has come up in a right time. As you mentioned, and as Dr. Ganguly is mentioning, the case positivity rate across the country is now around 8.5%. However, in Delhi, it is 2%. In Kerala and Tamil Nadu, still it is in two digit, 18% and 19%. So mm-hmm. for each state, we need a different strategy. So we cannot go for a single strategy for whole of the country, because the number of cases, fatalities, case positivity rate, everything is different. So it is an appropriate measure that the central government has brought in place. And it is complementing the previous ICMR directions as well regarding the testing. So it is complementing and supplementing each other. And the new directions that are being added with regard to the community engagement, I find that as very interesting and engaging with the community. When you bring in the civil society organizations, faith-based organization, NGOs into the picture, and when you increase the community's overall engagement, the chances that the public will adhere to the measures will be more. So okay. I find that as an interesting aspect, apart from the vaccination, which the guidelines is telling we have to try to reach out to 100% vaccination for all the eligible age groups at the earliest. So I feel this is a positive move from the central government.
So that's pretty much you know, important out there, Dr. Bhatt, as you said, and obviously vaccination is a very, very significant part of this multi-pronged strategy against COVID-19. But let's also understand how effective has this containment strategy or the lockdown strategy has been since day one. Bring in you know, Dr. Ganguly again here. Dr. Ganguly, from your perspective, how would you assess the impact of, you know, the lockdown strategy or the containment strategy which we adopted from day one so far? There have been various tweaks along the way, but how, you know, has it helped us in this battle against COVID-19, and what has been its effectiveness?
Actually, Vishal, what happened during the first lockdown, it was not only bending the curve to build up the infrastructure also, and we built up a lot of infrastructure. During second lockdown, we learned some of the deficiencies in the infrastructure, supply chains, as well as inventories. We have now learned a lot of things in this lockdown, and we have recommended it. Now there, we will have to display the availability of the hospital bed in a central part so that people don't have to run to five hospitals to get a bed. So information, we have also said that for the vaccination, those who are street workers, homeless workers, those who do not have education or migrant, they can go to any sector, any state and get themselves. So Aadhaar card is not a necessity. They could go and they could register themselves right on the vaccination center. Vaccination centers will also be displayed very rightly. So one of the things which government should do that it should create a metric for implementation and monitoring, because for any public health measures, any other measures, it should do that. It should really do a better surveillance system and ask the different agencies in our country to do their work and coordinate so that surveillance data could be used for prediction. Then there is another very major thing which we need to do now, that while we were measuring infrastructure, other things, here we should ramp up the vaccination. And government is already doing that. Okay. What government is trying to do, that it has brought in three or four things, that vaccine production, it has seen to it that vaccine production will increase. The second thing, that many of the companies which were only drug manufacturers, it has brought them into vaccine production, Reddy's Lab, the Hitro, Aurobindo, all of these were not vaccine producers. Even Cipla has come as a vaccine producer. Then the Sputnik will be available now. So there will be ramped up of production. There will be Sputnik available already. Zydus Cadila has applied for openness. And I hear that it has actually solved the issues with Pfizer for 5 crore vaccines. This need to be used in a special way. It should need to protect the pregnant woman. It should also be used to protect the children of 12 to 18. It will also provide later on an opportunity to immunize the children from 2 and above. So vaccine centers have been enhanced. So we need to see now that vaccine procurement happens seamlessly and smoothly. Vaccine should reach their endpoints very smoothly. Vaccination centers should vaccinate everybody. Now the time for the priorities have gone. We have prioritized, we have now vaccinated. Our aim will be, America has vaccinated 50%, Israel has 100%. So many countries have vaccinated, and those advanced countries who have not vaccinated, like Japan, has vaccinated only 2%. So Japan is in a big trouble. They will not be able to hold Olympics. because just 2% vaccination doesn't really open up the economy.
Indeed, so, Dr. Ganguly, as far as the vaccination is concerned, you're right, you know, the goal and the strategy here is to go ahead and vaccinate all. But one point which you made earlier, and I'd like to bring Dr. Lekha Bhatt here on that, is surveillance being very, very integral and important part of this containment strategy. Obviously, testing, tracking is important. So is surveillance, Dr. Bhatt. And how far, how are we doing on the surveillance part? Because surveillance gives us an idea as to where do we stand in terms of, you know, specific areas where the infection might be spreading at a faster rate, or areas where we've been able to control it.
Surveillance, both active surveillance and passive surveillance, are very important at this stage. And as Dr. Ganguly pointed out, we have also started active surveillance as of with this new strategy. So that is very important. At the same time, people are still not ready to come forward for testing. People are not ready to come forward for vaccination. So there is some gap in the health communication. So what I feel is that health communication needs to be strengthened further, and it should be tailored to the needs of the population. So whatever strategies we are using for health communication for an urban population will not suit for rural population. So similarly with other groups. So you need to have a multi-prolonged different type of a health communication strategy so that the people will be willing, consciously and willingly coming forward. And thus, active as well as passive surveillance strategies will become simpler for the state or the government to implement. Same way, curbing the false news circulation in the social media, which I feel is very important, because recently there are two news that have been circulated. For example, one is some Nobel laureate telling that vaccination will lead to death. Then doing multiple tests of antigen test or RT-PCR test multiple times will create problems in your blood. So this type of false propaganda and false news has to be controlled. So I think these are the other areas which we have to strengthen so that surveillance will become more stricter in terms of testing, treating, and vaccination.
Okay, indeed, it is not just pandemic which we are fighting here, it's the infodemic here as well, something which we have discussed quite a number of times on this show. Dr. Ganguly, you know, this point I'd like to bring to you, quite important. We can put in place various strategies, we can put in place plans as well, but all those plans will become successful only and only if they are communicated in a very effective manner to all the stakeholders. And here, the most important stakeholder is the common man, the general public. And therein comes the role of, you know, a community involvement as well as proper health communication, as Dr. Bhatt is saying.
Yeah, Dr. Bhatt is absolutely right, because the language which me and you are speaking, Vishal, may not be understood by the person in the villages, migrants and others, because they are also getting advice from many other village elders or their elders or other sources. And vaccine hesitancy was always here, whether it was a polio vaccination, and there's an anti-vaccine lobby which goes to the court and tries to block this. So we need to get the communication experts, create languages, create systems so that people's misgivings are removed. And we need to involve NGOs in a very, very big way, because NGOs are the guys who actually are in touch with the people. So NGO system, we need to also look at, we have a very good network of public health institutes, and we have some very good experts which are not in the government, which are outside government, who are very good in communication. And we need to really empower the communities right at the grassroots level. So communities should become our partner in our endeavor. They should decide on the vaccination. They should also say that please vaccinate our villages. We will assemble in a mela kind of a thing, and we will do. I will end by saying one more important message, that we are having few other tools with us. The antibodies, the Regeneron antibody, Casimiravir and Medivip, both are being now supplied by Cipla and will be made by Cipla.
Okay.
And And there are others. Zydus Cadila has come up with two of its antibodies. So two other organizations are making. This will become cheaper. It will not cost 70,000 or other. It will become cheaper. So there we will have another tool to fight. And we have now data, real-time data, on the Covishield.
Mm-hmm.
This has come from UK. That although after first injection it is only 40%, but after second injection it comes up to 90%. And some real-time data from independent researchers from the organizations, Apollo, okay, Medanta, Gangaram, Max, what they have found that those who were immunized by two vaccination doses, they can easily deal with, these are from the health worker data, where they get a concentrated infection. They can deal with B1.617 variants. It can deal with the British variants. It can deal with any mutation now.
That is a very positive news.
Yeah, very positive thing. And number of people who got infected is very, very little, less than 4%. And none of them had to be hospitalized. There are some stray cases of doctors who have been immunized by two doses and they have died. They had a problem. Some had embolism, some had heart problem, and some died because they couldn't get the oxygen on time because of that particular moment that day. But if you really trace the doctors who died, there was a reason behind that. So these were vulnerable doctors with a vulnerable age with comorbidities, which were very, 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 very telling.
Okay. Indeed, let me have a quick concluding comment from you as well, Dr. Bhatt, before we bring this discussion to an end. In terms of, the road ahead for us, it's not that the battle against COVID-19 is over. We will have to keep our guard up at all times.
Yes, sir. As of now, we are able to bring down the number of cases and fatality rate. At the same time, we are expecting more cases in future. We don't know what is going to happen, whether third wave will come or will not come. It will be a minor one. It will be with a different kind of symptoms, slightly at least. So we don't know. So we have to step up our preparation in all directions, from starting at an individual level, micro level, to meso and macro level. The preparation has to be at a proper level. From an individual level, maintaining the proper COVID protocol, from masking to sanitizing, the regular things which we are now used to, or at least expected to be used to, and stepping up our health infrastructure and ensuring that our healthcare workers are not undergoing burnout or fatigue, preparation for having enough of ICU beds, oxygen supported beds, ambulance, increasing the number of availability of ambulances, and generating a positive environment so that we'll be able to meet the future requirement. At the same time, it is also important to look into the mental health aspect of the public as well as the healthcare workers, which is entirely a different dimension.
Indeed, and we have had a quite detailed discussion on that as well. We'll come and revisit that aspect also. Thank you so much, Dr. Lekha Bhatt, as well as Dr. N.K. Ganguly, for sharing your important views and insights on this very important aspect of the fight against COVID-19, which, as our experts are also saying, it is not yet over. We have achieved some amount of success in terms of dealing with the second wave, but we cannot let our guard down while the government, the administration is preparing itself with the containment strategies, with surveillance strategies, pushing with testing and tracking, as well as vaccination for all. We as citizens will also have to do our part and ensure that we adhere to the COVID-19 appropriate behavior at all times.
So
stay safe, take care.